Hope you enjoyed that montage, but after using this gun in PvP or the Crucible, I've noticed there's a lot of recoil on it, and it is really hard to control it on console. On PC, it would probably be way easier to use, considering like there's no recoil at all, or you can control it with your mouse. On console, it's really bad. I mean, there's some perks and magazines and barrels you could get on this gun that'll help it out, like dynamic sway, but in the second column for perks, there's not many that help out with stability or in PvP at all, in my opinion. But in PvE, this gun is pretty good because you could get really good perks on it. And the stability doesn't really matter because you're not really aiming for the head that much, or you don't need to aim for the head that much. And you could get Surplus, Subsistence, Rampage, One for All, and Surrounded, which I find are the best for this gun at least. There's also Dragonfly, which is not supposed to be on this weapon because it's a kinetic. They added it in by accident. You could only get this weapon from the Dawning event, which happens every year at Christmas or during the holidays. What you do is you give cookies to different vendors and you have a chance of getting a gift in return, which you could open and either get the Cold Front, Glacial Chasm, or the Avalanche, which is the submachine gun, the fusion rifle, and the LMG. Subsistence is gonna help you get your ammo back to your magazine, since you're gonna be killing enemies, and you're just gonna get portions of your magazine back to you every time you kill one. Surplus is gonna help you with the reload as well, as long as you don't spam your abilities, because you need your abilities to increase your reload speed. Rampage increases the weapon's damage by 60 to 65%, and One for All increases the weapon's damage by 35%. But with Rampage, you actually need to kill the enemies to activate, and with One for All, you just need to hit 3 different enemies to activate it, and it lasts for 10 seconds. I feel like One for All would be better for higher difficulty encounters, because you just need to hit the enemies, you don't actually need to kill them, and you just get the damage buff by 35%. With Rampage, I feel like it would be better for lower tier enemies or lower tier encounters for ad clear, and it would also be good for damage output too. Another difference is with Rampage, you could use Rampage spec, and with One for All, you could use minor spec. The god roll for this weapon for PvE, I feel like would be Subsistence or Surplus with Rampage or One for All. Subsistence and Rampage would go well together for lower tier encounters, and Subsistence and Surplus with One for All would be better for higher tier or more difficult encounters. But I would not recommend this gun for PvP, or at least for console, because it's hard to control the recoil, especially on controller. If you're using this gun on PC, you could always get dynamic sway and unrelenting, and that would probably help out with your stability and handling a little bit, but I still wouldn't recommend this for PvP. But yeah, that's the cold front. This is my advice when you get this gun and what to look for the perks. When comparing it to the Aikalos SMG, it does have lower stats, and the Aikalos SMG also could spawn in Warmind cells, but I feel like the cold front has a better perk selection. Anyways, that's my review on the cold front SMG from the Dawning event. I hope you guys enjoyed, and make sure to like, subscribe, and comment, and see you in the next video.